know.
More people.
Welcome to this. Oh yeah, welcome to the session. Carlos here. Check this out.
Are you looking to generate more leads and you want to figure out a way to run a successful campaign? Well, I have that solution for you. On this training event, I'm going to teach you three common mistakes real estate agents do when promoting their listing and three things you should do while promoting your listing. So the name of the game is to get the consumer in the door. And that's what I'm going to do on this training event, is teach you how to run a successful campaign. My name is Brandon Tate, and I hope to see you there.
The man of the hour. Thank you again. And we do have Robert on the call as well. I see you there, Robert. Thank you for joining. And Adam, I see you there as well. So I believe the way you guys are going to present this is Brandon's going to start. Robert and Adam have some amazing value adds as well. They're running an awesome team for sale in Georgian Bay. And we can't wait to hear what you've done. When I heard your story, Brandon, with just, I think you said the last four deals all being a result of the command boosting and ads you're putting through Facebook. Yep. I couldn't wait to have you speak. So thank you for your time.
Yeah, thank you for having me. I really do appreciate it. This is kind of a really good duo. Myself and Robert are going to be going over some pretty detailed things. I'm going to be discussing kind of the overview, and then he's going to go a little bit more into detail based on kind of what I've just discussed. So pens and papers, you guys ready? Let's do this. Okay, I'm a little nervous, so I'm going to take a little sip of water and get started.
I'll be nervous.
You got it. You're awesome. Okay, thank you, Brandon, Robert, and Adam. Take it away.
Perfect. Let's do this. All right. So, Carlos, am I able to share my screen?
Go ahead.
Let's do this. Cool. So I'm going to start off with my little presentation here. All right, let's do this. Cool. So authentic marketing, just be you. That's just a super important thing with generating leads, promoting your campaigns, or doing any of that kind of stuff. Just be you. When you start to not be yourself, you kind of look awkward on camera, and it just doesn't represent exactly who you are. So be you. My mission statement: connecting with customers more authentically, market ideas more imaginatively to come up with innovative solutions to make a meaningful mark on everyone we help. So who is Brandon Tate? So this right here is my family. I got my little guy, Leo. I got my beautiful girlfriend, Victoria. And then I got my little guy, Romeo. So I have the desire and the ambition to succeed no matter how hard the task is. It's not considered failure unless I give up. So I'm just going to go into a little bit of detail here. So I've been with Keller Williams for about a year and 4 months now. I was originally over at the Mississauga office, Keller Williams Real Estate Associates. I made the transition over from that office to the Barry office because I decided to move up to Aurelia. And why did I move up to Aurelia? Most importantly for my family, because it was a better quality of life. And I was able to connect with people a little bit more authentically. I found kind of going from the city, going up to Aurelia, I just found it was just a different culture, different environment, which is what I was really happy about. With that being said, it's important for you to understand consumer behavior and how to market your ideas. So with Brandon Tate, I've been a real estate agent for a year and 4 months. And I've been getting a lot of success generating leads on command. And again, I'm talking from a solo agent's perspective. I don't spend a lot of money on generating leads through command. So you'll see, I'll show you my budget, what I spend and how many leads I come in. Because if I'm spending like $400, $500, $600, $700 a month on generating leads, I'm gonna get really overwhelmed. And things are just going to fall between the cracks. So with that being said, I'm talking from a solo agent's perspective, and you'll see the amount of leads that I do have coming in. It's kind of like when I go door knocking, I'll generate X amount of leads. And when I'm doing command leads, I'm generating X amount of leads, so I don't let things fall between the cracks. Sorry, guys. So that's Brandon Tate. So today I'm going to discuss a brief overview. These are the three things I'm going to discuss today. Five common mistakes when running a social ad, three things you should do when advertising a listing, and then the softwares I use to separate myself to create a unique presence on social media. So during the beginning of this, it says three common mistakes, and I kind of evaluated a little bit deeper, and I came up with five common mistakes that I kind of want to dive into a little bit more. Sorry. So five common mistakes, hitting the boost button. A lot of agents tend to post something on Facebook, and then what they like to do is they see, okay, I have 300,000 people looking at this, 500,000 people, a million people looking at this. Those numbers are dramatic. But the idea of it is people look at kind of just the impressions. Sure, the impressions are great. But what you need to have is you need to have the clicks, and you need to also generate the information. So it's kind of like when you go door knocking, you don't want to just knock on 200 doors, talk to 10 people, and only get one person in your database. It's the same thing with social ads. You don't want to have, you know, 500,000 impressions, only 20 clicks, and only one person. You only gather one person's information. That's not lucrative. So allow me to elaborate this. Hitting the boost button. Do not do why, because it's the lazy way to run ads. People always look at, oh, I'm getting tons of impressions. It's useless. Not using the right algorithm based on the content you're running. So based on the content you're running, you need to figure out who you're trying to target and why are you trying to target them? And I'll go into detail of some campaigns that I've created.
What's daddy say?
Daddy said, good job. Okay. So yeah, going back to that. So basically you got to figure out the campaign that you're running, and you want to make sure you're targeting the right people. And then you also want to make sure that you're using Facebook Ads Manager. It allows you to gain more control on what you're trying to do. So when you're using the campaign, the manager, it allows you to tailor specific things on who you're trying to target. And Robert's going to go more into detail about that. But when you highlight more things on who you want to target. So if you're looking for someone who's a first-time home buyer, you're going to put in that algorithm first-time home buyers, okay? And then if you're looking for someone who's generating, like coming from the city, you want to ensure that you're targeting people in the city. And then number two is targeting the wrong audience. Now, with targeting the wrong audience, do your research on where you want to target. That's huge. And who I want to target and why I want to target them. And then pay to run the ad in that area to capture the right lead. So what I like to do is I like to do a very strong coming soon period where it allows me to gather information on my listing, my area. I figure out where the buyers are coming from. And then I also alter the information and I say, okay, based on the information that I've gathered today, why is this important and how can I put this on a social ad to generate it in an area where I want the buyers to come view my property? And then advertising without value. That's the biggest. You want to make sure you're advertising with the highest amount of value. So every click of the way, someone's either brought to like a landing page, a dedicated property page on your listing. If they're looking at, for instance, if they're looking at your ad and it says the learn more button, you want to make sure that you're putting the information there saying, click here to find out how much your home's worth, and then send them to a landing page to see how much their home's worth so that it gives them a better idea. And then when you find that information, you can then give them a call like immediately. Like if someone just left their information and I got a notification, I'll call them within and under an hour and I'll say, hi, I see that you just inquired about how much your home's worth. In order for me to give you a better accurate how much your home's worth, be best advised if I were to come by, does tomorrow at 3 p.m. work for you? And you just lead with the conversation. You tell them like, does this time work for you? You know, and you give them an exact time. Because if you say to them, oh, does Monday to Friday work between 1 and 3? And they say, oh, no, the whole week doesn't work. So now that's completely out of the discussion. And then going back to advertising without value, you always want to make sure you provide value first with content that will inspire, inform, and entertain your audience. That's the most important. So when you're running an ad, you want to make sure within the first 3 seconds, you're capturing their attention. So if the ad's running and they're scrolling through and it's like, stop what you're doing. I have exactly what you've been looking for. Boom. That just stopped them right in their tracks because they're going through and then you just stop them. That's the most important thing. You actually want to stop them in their tracks while they're going through. So I don't do a lot of photos when I run my campaigns or when I run my ads, because I like to make it a little bit more authentic, because when people look at my campaigns and my ads, I want to ensure that when they see my campaign, they say, oh, that's Brandon Tate. Because I want them to see a video. I want them to connect with me. I want them to see a video of me so that they can say, oh, that was personable. You know, now I can relate to this guy, or his personality rubbed me off this way, or this or that. So that's what I like to do. And then going over to not testing variations. Now, Robert's going to cover this in his slide and how he covers specific zones and stuff, but not testing and trying different variations. So having the same ad running multiple times, then pinpointing the one that is performing the best and running it again. So basically what I'm trying to say is, if you have 3 campaigns, okay, they're all the same. So for instance, say it's a listing on 123 Main Street, okay? 123 Main Street, you have it running 3 different times. You have one running in Mississauga, one running in Innisfil, and one running in Barrie, okay? Based on those coverage areas, you're gonna look, what I like to do is the first 2 days, I run my campaigns between 12 to 16 days. So within that first 2 days, I get a really good idea of how my campaign is performing. So with those 3 different covered zones, I say, okay, wow, Mississauga, it's not working too well, okay? I'm trying to attract people coming from the city because a lot of people right now are moving up to Simcoe County, but a lot of people from Barrie are looking to move to Midland or Orillia or Gravenhurst or wherever it may be. So if you look at those ads that are running, you see, okay, this one's running at $3 per lead, $1.25, 40 cents, boom. The one with 40 cents, you then grab these other 2 leads that are not performing very well in Mississauga and Barrie, then you transfer them to Innisfil, all right? Say Innisfil is the one that's performing the best. You now grab those other two campaigns, you push them all the way to the Innisfil one, and now you're tripling up on your lead. And you're advertising in that one specific area. So with me, I usually run my leads at probably about $40. So 40, 40, 40. Again, it's not a big budget, but again, I'm a solo agent. And if I was spending $100, $100, $100, I'd be way too overwhelmed and I wouldn't be able to do what I need to do. And in order to provide my clients and my customers with the highest amount of value and provide them good customer service. So I push those leads there. And then now I see that the other campaigns that were running at $3 and $2, I push them to Innisfil that the other ones are running at 40 cents. Now those ones are performing really well. And every time you're scrolling through your phone, you see my campaign, you scroll through every 15 slides, you see my campaign, you scroll through again, you now see my campaign. So now I'm tripling up on the exposure that the consumer will see on their phone. Does anyone have any questions about that? Because I went really into detail about that. Carlos, maybe you want to let the
anybody want to ask a question, feel free to raise a hand or send on chat or talk. You're free to unmute if you want. Anyone?
Brandon, maybe you could just share quickly what is a campaign for those that might not be understanding of the KW back end.
Totally, yes.
As opposed to the comparison with just putting an ad out on Facebook.
Yep, absolutely, yep. So I'll just finish up with the last mistake, never getting started. It's that simple. A lot of people just get overwhelmed. They look at it and they're like, okay, this is too hard to learn. The thing is, go on YouTube, reach out to you, Carlos, reach out to people. If you don't know how to create a campaign, you got to figure it out. You know, you watch a YouTube. I watch a lot of YouTube videos on how to do things. And that's where I've done a lot of my learning, because YouTube's free. All you got to do is just type in something you don't know. You gather all this information and you go from there. All right. So this is basically my campaign and my ad. So I'll show you guys exactly what the live version's like. But again, as a solo agent, I spent $20. This is my coming soon on the left-hand side here. This is my coming soon period. So as I was mentioning, do strong coming soon periods, because I spent $20 for 4 days, got 22 leads. Okay. Out of those 22 leads, I had two buyers very interested. Okay. Very interested. And they both were fighting with each other when it came time to the hold offer date. So I technically sold this property before it went on the market, but my client requested me to do a hold offer period and stayed to that date. So with that being said, because I got people coming in the door during the coming soon period, and I made them feel like VIP. I said, look, guys, I'll get you in, but the property's not fully ready yet, but you know what? I can get you in. Although the property was fully ready and was ready to go, I was making them feel special. I was like, you know what? Honestly, I'll get you in before it goes on the market. So I let these people come in through the property. I built the attraction. I built the momentum. I built the attention to the property so that when it came to the offer date, they were definitely going to pull the trigger and get going on the property. So needless to say, this property, because I did this, a lot of marketing on it, sold $150,000 above asking. Crazy. So it sold $150,000 above asking, and it was the highest sale on the street. And then same with the one right beside it. This one's in Aurelia. This one I did $60, ran it for 16 days. I got 52 leads. Okay. So can you guys go door knocking and get 52 contacts in 16 days? Some people can, some people can't. But you can have your campaign running while going door knocking, get maybe 20 contacts, and then add to that 52. So while you're having one thing work for you, and again, and this is leveraging my time off, because I'm having a campaign run, I'm leveraging off, and I can still go door knocking while being a little bit more personable and interacting with people. So with this campaign, again, this is my first campaign that I ever ran right here. I got 75,000 impressions, 80 clicks, zero leads here, because I didn't use the Facebook form manager. So when you use Facebook form manager, you go on Facebook and you click, leave your information, and it's already auto-filled, and then it's submitted. So I didn't do that the first one, but I remember when I got this campaign, I got 42 leads from it. So I got well over 100 leads on this one campaign. And then based on just the information here, as we can see, I ran it for 14.5 days, got 957 clicks with 93 leads. And now based on those 93 leads, I'm still working with them to this day. Still working to them to this day. And will they be selling right now? No, but they'll be selling within the next year. So I have my database and I have my work set for me when it does come time, because they were so impressed with the marketing and how I sold this house for the highest sold in the area. And with the marketing that I did, I left an everlasting impression because I marketed the property differently than a lot of people in the area. And as you can see, I spent $120. So for a solo agent to run three campaigns, I think that's fantastic. Cool. Now we're going to go into three things.
Brandon, you go back one slide? I think this is pretty incredible. So this 3032 Monarch, is that the one?
Yep.
Two ads you ran. So you got 41 leads for the one and 52 for the other.
Yep.
With a total spend of 100 and, sorry, my brain's not great with math, right? But that's pretty awesome. So did you call those leads?
Oh, yeah. So how it looked is basically once I got a notification, and just so you know, during the exclusive period, I got probably at least at minimum 15 people through the door prior. And I ended up selling this property to another real estate agent in Toronto who sold her townhouse. And how did I know she sold her townhouse? Because I looked her up on GeoWarehouse. I looked up her information and I looked her up on Google. And I noticed that she was converting. She was moving to Simcoe County anyways. So I knew she really wanted this house. And I know she was playing hardball. And the thing is, she knew she was overpaying for this house by $50,000 to $60,000 at the time. But I insured her. I brought value to the agent. And I said, look, I said, I understand you feel like you're overpaying now, but I can assure you right now, within the next year and a half, 2 years, this property is going to be well over $1 million. Needless to say, within under a year, house just sold down the street for $1,087,000. And this house sold for $780,000. And the other highest sold on the street, which had a finished basement, it was fully loaded, sold for $720,000. So this one didn't have a finished basement. Awesome. So again, you just got to bring value each step of the way. So again, I'm going over this information now, but I'm going to show you the live demo of it in just 3 seconds. So I'll go over here and I'll go over to the campaign. And then let me know if you guys can hear the video on this.
Quality of life. Well, you could do so. My name is Brandon Tate, and I'm pleased to present someone who's looking to get out of the city and enjoy a better quality of life. Well, you could do so. My name is Brandon Tate, and I'm pleased to present to you 3032 Monarch Drive, located here in beautiful Aurelia. Now, this home has a lot to offer, with 4 bedrooms, 4 bathrooms, with 2,780 square feet of livable space on a 69 by 109 corner lot. This could be the home for you. So why don't you come along and join me for the tour?
Sorry, I don't know why it looks so dark right now. It doesn't look this dark. Okay, so the moral of the story of this one is that basically what that campaign in the intro is, are you someone who's looking to get out of the city and enjoy a better quality of life? Well, you could do so. Because at that specific time and at that specific moment, after calling everyone in the area, I noticed all the buyers were coming from the city, the GTA. So I said, okay, I have to create a marketing campaign that's specifically tailored to those people who are coming from outside the city. How did I do that? I called other agents in the area and I said, look, where are your buyers coming from? They said, here. So I said, okay, out of those 5 areas and tallying them off, I said, okay, majority of your people are coming from Mississauga, Toronto, Etobicoke. All right, so I'm going to run a campaign in those 3 areas. And whatever one started performing better, like I just mentioned, I grabbed the other 2 that weren't performing as good and I tripled up the campaign information onto the other ones. So that's what I did. And I made that tailored to that specific property. I'm just going to go over to the next slide. Okay.
Hey, Brandon.
Hey.
This is Phil Legree in Vancouver. I just got to say right out of the gate, outstanding video. Like,
oh,
it's really a great job, because I Corcha Mon people, I was 25 years in television before real estate, but just the right amount of you. You're there, you're part of it. Mm-hmm. Because so many people walk around are nervous about camera. You don't ever have to be on camera. That's number one. It's nice. Yep. But this whole thing where they walk around and go, these are my nose hairs. Behind me, there's a 2-bedroom. Over there, there's a this and that. And they walk around with their face in the camera. And over here is, and down the street is that, you know, just a couple seconds on camera for anybody is more than enough. And if you're nervous about that, do the same video with your voice. Anyway, I just had to compliment you, because it was just so classy and so good. And it wasn't about you, but the house, but you just became so recognizable in those few seconds. So
I really awesome. Do appreciate it. Hey, it means the world to me. Thank you for your acknowledgement, and thank you for noticing that. I appreciate it. So now I'm just going to toss over to the next campaign that I just want to show you guys that I created. And this is the coming soon period that I did. So I'll go into more detail after. So now this one is more slower, it's more cinematic, but the idea is just to kind of make people feel excited. So I also choose all my music too. I choose all my music based on the properties and how I feel about the property and the vibe that it gives me. And I kind of grab that vibe and I put it into music. And then I hope that it will inspire the consumer and they say, oh, this property looks nice. I like the music too, you know? So you got to also make sure you're tailoring the music to what you do. Cause I focus more on videos rather than photos. So again, this is the coming soon period. And with this one, I generated 22 leads for only 4 days. Again, it's not a whole whack load, but again, I'm a solo agent. And based on those 22 leads, I can manage that. And I can still do door knocking. And I can still go showing my clients properties while being able to manage all the leads that are coming in. So that's why I don't spend too much money on that. And then this is the other campaign that I ran in Midland. So this property, actually, I've already had 3 accepted offers on this. My clients are waiting financing, but I sold this property within a week in Midland. And we know with the Midland market right now, houses are not selling very quick. But this is another campaign that I recently just created. And you'll see how I capture the audience's attention right off the bat.
Looking for. Stop what you're doing, because I have exactly what you've been looking for. Situated on a 70 by 260 foot lot, backing onto a mature forest in the sought after community of Sunnyside, located right here in Midland. Now this property is walking distance from Midland Bay, where you will find Bayport Yacht Club, offering all your boating desires, located right at your fingertips. With 3 bedrooms, 3 bathrooms, and 2,000 square feet of living space, this is the property for you. Without further ado, my name is Brandon Tate, and I'm pleased to present to you 1308 Everton Road, located right here in Midland. Let's go for a tour.
So now, again, with this one, I try to stop the consumers right in their tracks. Just stop what you're doing. You know, I just stop. Because I have exactly what you've been looking for. And that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to stop the consumer so that they understand, like, I have something for them and I want to show them what I have for them. So I'm trying to inspire them and I'm trying to motivate them to come to this property before it goes on the market or when it is on the market. And then going back to my slides now. Any questions here? Thumbs up, thumbs down. Any questions, debates?
I just want to have a quick comment. It's great. Like we talked before, when we do our one-on-one sessions, Brandon, that video really did well. The first 5 seconds really counted because you immediately captured the attention of the client in the first 5 seconds. Because in Facebook, you have the ability to skip, right? Yep. So in the first 5 seconds, if you ask that question, you get their attention and now there's engagement. Some, yep. most agents, you know, trying to do this the first time, they create a great video and the first 10 seconds is just an overhead shot without that engagement piece. And that drastically affects the results of the ad.
Yep,
but
I agree.
Great job.
Thank you. And while we're on that, like you're saying, you know, capturing the audience's attention within that first 5 seconds, what I've noticed is that when you start off a video by saying, hi there, my name is Brandon Tate with, you know, Keller Williams Experience Realty, and I have the perfect property for you, they're not interested. Don't start off with your name. Don't tell who you work for. Don't. It's just another traditional real estate video. It doesn't work. It doesn't capture the audience attention and they just slide through. Oh, this is just another real estate video. Move forward. But again, if you just say, stop what you're doing, I have exactly what you're looking for. And it's like, okay, what does he have for me? You know? Now we're going to go over to 3 things you should do when promoting your listing. Now, these are the 3 things that I always do when I promote my listing. I have strict structures, systems, and models that I always follow when I do my listing because I follow a specific board. Allow me to expand the screen. All right. And have incredible coming soon marketing done prior to going on the market. So again, you want to make sure that you have good marketing done. So I have a drone. I have a professional camera. Not saying you guys got to go out and go spend that kind of money, but look on YouTube how to take incredible photos and videos on your iPhone. And I'm going to show you that in just 30 seconds, a little bit longer than that. But you want to make sure that you have these good photos and good videos, because again, you want to make sure that when you're promoting your campaign, you have something that's going to inspire and attract the consumer. If you have just bad photos, if you grab photos from Google Maps, people are going to be like, whoa, that's a brutal looking property. You know, so you want to make sure that you have something that's going to inspire the consumer. Going back to what I said earlier, to call the most recent sales in the area. Talk to the buyer's agent. If you notice that 8 properties just sold in the area and they all sold $70,000 above asking, why did they sell $70,000 above asking? Where did the buyers come from? Why did the buyers move there? And what made them fall in love with the community? Gather all those informations, because now I'm already preparing my next script in my head for my next listing. So when I get all this information, the buyer's agent's actually making my job easier, because he's telling me why has buyers moved to the area, why they love it so much. And then I do my research on the area and I say, okay, this is how I'm going to tailor this, and this is how I'm going to do this. So I prepare my next script by talking to the buyer's agent and gathering information, let alone I'm also figuring out where I'm going to target my campaigns. So number two is one of the most important. And then having incredible marketing is also really important too. And then number three is huge, because you need to be able to follow up with everyone that's inquiring. Got to call them. Hey, I see that you just inquired about this property. How can I help you? What caught your attention to this property? Oh, your video, it was really well done. And why was it really well done? Oh, because it just, I was scrolling through my Facebook page and it stopped me right in my track. And again, this is information that I'm hearing from consumers. It's not information I'm telling you. This is information that I heard from consumers that I'm now relaying back to you guys. You want to make sure that you follow through. So if someone says to me, Brandon, I need you to send me a detailed list of what the property has, or the information the property has, can you look into this for me? Is it going to have high-speed internet in this area? Because we're moving from Toronto, we want to ensure that it has high-speed internet. Look up the service providers in the area. Make sure that you follow through with what you're going to say, you're going to do, and then follow back and then tell them, like, look, hey, just want to touch base with you and let you know that based on the information you guys asked of me, here's so-and-so, here's so-and-so. And they say, oh, well, that was quick, you know, and I do it immediately. I write everything down and I say, boom, this is what I have for you. So three things, biggest takeaways. I think you guys take this down because this is huge. And then next, let's talk about marketing ideas. Now, I'll show you how I market my properties, whether it's a coming soon period or whether it's, you know, just trying to make a presence on social media. And I don't want to talk too much because I got to get Robert on the call. So I'm just going to go over here, quickly show you guys what I do for social, for marketing and stuff. So now I just want to show you guys. So this video that I have here, you can now grab this video, put it in command, and create a marketing campaign. Here's what one, this is Mississauga, but so you can grab this video, put it on a campaign, and create the campaign title, are you looking to move to Aurelia? Here's what 579 can get you, blah, 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 3 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms. And you, now this is a campaign, you know, you can create a campaign. So it's just different ideas, and this, you can use TikTok for so many different things. I took this video just only on my phone using the 0.5 lens. And you make it cinematic, you make it entertaining. And then again, you got to make sure you look at consumers' behaviors. So what does the consumer like? Based on this, I see, again, I just started doing this, but I'm reading the information, 681 views. Okay, 335, 427. Based on the information I see here, why did this one get so much more likes? Well, A, I'll tell you right now, it's a hot trending song right now by Justin Bieber. So that's one reason why. And two, I made it interesting. I showed the property and its selling features. So again, you gotta read the information, you gotta read the consumer's behavior, and you gotta adapt and acknowledge what they like and what they don't like. If they like something, go with it. If you don't like it, but they like it, just go with it, right? So you can use TikTok for numerous amount of things, and you can create the video, save it to your phone, and then put it on a campaign ad, which, Robert will go into detail probably about that too. But again, you want to make sure that you're providing value. So if you're providing value to the consumer, depending on where they're clicking on the coming soon period. So if you go back over here, okay, you go back over here and the learn more button. Okay. Coming soon to Waterloo, click here to get in touch. So when you click learn more, I'll redirect them to here. So when I redirect them here, they put their information in, they leave a note. I call them within under 30 minutes and I say, hey, I see that you just inquired about so-and-so property. How can I help you today? Well, I want to come by and view it. Excellent. Does tomorrow at 4 p.m. work for you? Yes, it does. Excellent. Be sure to meet you at the property. Done. I have their information. I also asked them to send me a photo of their driver's license so I know who I'm going out with. But other than that, like, you got to provide value. Like, be quick, be immediate. People are not going to wait for you. Customers are not loyal to you. They're loyal to the services you provide. And if you're providing strong services, immediate, fast response, that's what they want. Another thing, we'll go back over here. For sale, who wants to move out of the city and into a large 4-bedroom house? So right here, you got this one. When you click learn more, it sends us, like, not this one right here, because the dedicated property page I took down. But you can click information where it's like, okay, well, I want to move out of the city, but what's the first thing I need to do? I need to sell my house. Okay. So you go to sellers, go to home worth. So I bring them to a dedicated property page here. What's your home worth? They have no idea. They're like, okay, well, I'm moving out of the city. I don't know what my home's worth. So this gives them an up-to-date information on what their home's worth. It's not 100% accurate, but now it leaves a good impression that I was able to give them information right off the bat. Now I'll say to them, just so you know, I can come by your property this day to give you a much more accurate information on what your home's actually worth. Does that sound like a good idea? Or I just say to them, like, do you want to know more about your property and how it stands up in the marketplace and a better idea of what your home's exactly worth? They say yes. I said, okay, excellent. And I come by and I give them a comparative market analysis and I go more into detail. But like I said, you got to make sure that you're providing value each click of the way on the learn more button. So you go learn more. You got to make sure that it goes somewhere. You got to make sure it goes somewhere useful, because if it goes to like your face, like if it just goes here, I'll show you. Like if I'm just bringing them over to this side of the page and they just read about me and they're like, okay, well, I don't really care, to be completely honest with you. You know, they want to be dedicated somewhere with value. So if they go to I put the learn more button here and it's like, okay, now it's all the information that they wanted on the property. Do I need to call the agent? The only reason why they'll call me now is because they're interested, because they have all the information in front of them. So I eliminate objections and I eliminate the in-between period and I just go straight to the point. Give them the information, bring value. They call me, hey, Brandon, I want to view the property. So basically social media branding that I use, TikTok, Instagram, Facebook. And then to create your authentic marketing, you got to make sure that, I'm not too sure if you guys have ever heard of Canva. A Canva is a good way to market your property, your ideas, and your marketing information differently. Like with this one, you know, you can I can delete all this. So with all this information, you guys should make a quick note, use Canva. So grab your photos, transfer it to Canva, and you can kind of tailor, okay, this property is this property is this big, and you can put the lines here. So, and then all these photos here, you can then put them on a coming soon or on a for sale on a paid campaign. Anyone have any questions about what I've just discussed?
Well, Carlos here, we have a lot of questions. Great session so far. We're trying to cover as much of those questions as we can. After our Robert here.
He's got to get on.
For those who are asking if this is this is recorded, definitely for KWA and KWE agents. For our guests, please type your email address and send it to me, and we'll do our best to help you out. I'm going to take it over to Robert. Yep. And Adam. Thank you, Brandon. That was amazing.
Yep.
Amazing work. Okay, go ahead.
Hey, Carlos. Sorry.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah, go ahead, Phil.
No, I was just going to throw it. Brandon, I know I used Canva forever. I've completely given it up. I see no purpose for it anymore. Designs is so amazing in campaigns. And when you use designs, it automatically imports all of your listing photos and everything right to them. So I know they're both super useful, but I'm just having the power with designs. It's been phenomenal.
Yeah, I just wanted to interrupt there. So basically, based on designs and stuff, I don't disagree, designs is fantastic.
Yeah.
But with designs, a lot of real estate agents use designs because they don't use their own marketing. So it doesn't really separate you. How can you separate yourself from others? How can you make yourself different, right?
Excellent point. Love it.
Yeah. Thanks.
Are we live in action, Carlos?
Go ahead. Shoot. All right.
Okay. Well, hi, everyone. Thanks, Brandon, for all your work on that. You're certainly very thorough and showed a lot of really great examples. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Sorry it took so long. You guys are going to kill it now.
I'm Rob. This is Adam. We're from Salem, Georgian Bay. We're located in Midland, but cover all of Sonoma County. We just celebrated our first year anniversary. Right now we have 10 agents, 2 admin staff. And our agents are killing it right now. Really proud of everything they're doing. So we're gonna be talking about adapting to social media during COVID. We launched during COVID, so we were born in the shift. So we instantly had to try a new way of approaching everything. So we focused on social media. We used all the traditional methods, and we're a team that wants to get out into the community. We want to door knock, we want to see people, meet people. We want presence on billboards and postcards, but with everything the way it was last year, there's less people out. Billboards are not going to be seen as much. People don't want to touch stuff. People don't want to handle stuff. So we funneled the majority of our efforts into social media. And that actually resulted, after our first year, 40% of our traffic to our website came through social media referrals, which resulted in the best dollar value return on investment of all our advertising streams. So we're gonna take a little look at building brand recognition and brand awareness through social media, how to provide value to your viewers. It's not just about getting clicks and leads. There's so many layers of effectiveness through social media ads. So brand recognition is where the general public can identify your brand amongst others purely from the visual symbols, your logos, your style, your tone of voice. These are all really important elements in building your brand, and social media is a great spot to do that. So this is how we do it. We make sure that all our ads have a consistent feel to them, strong visual identity. They're all similar. We don't want people to just see a real estate ad. We want them to see a For Sale in Georgian Bay ad. And so we keep all our written content short. We don't want it to say see more. We don't, because there's too much text. So we keep a short headline. We always include the address, cover that later in providing value. And all our images are the same. We use the same icons for each listing. A logo is always in the same place, and we always include a little blue fade at the bottom of the image so that the icons are visible and that it just stylizes each image in the same way. I don't believe that our ads get seen any more than our competitors. We're all doing the same thing. We're all doing the same tactics. But one thing that we do get told a lot is that I see your ads all the time. And I think that that's actually what we're being told, is that when they're not just seeing our ads all the time, it's the fact that they remember our ads compared to other real estate ads that are filling up social media timelines. And that's a really important thing, because that brings us to brand awareness. And this is a great thing that social media can do, is that you can you don't, it's like I said, it's not about the clicks, it's not about the leads, it's so many more layers than that. But you've got to give your viewers something that they can walk away from your ad having viewed. So we make sure that we provide value in the ad. So many times you seek ads that are just clickbait and not click-worthy. But you want to provide repetition to your audience. You will then get engagement with clicks and comments and likes and shares. And every time someone comments on it, it increases the algorithm that it's going to show up in more people's feeds organically, not just through paid advertising. So creating the value, there's so many social media ads for real estate where you see the first comment on it is price, location, because whoever is running the ad has decided that, oh, they're going to click through to see that. All that does is it just kind of irritates the viewer, and it also increases your bounce rate on your website if someone is just clicking through to your website just to see a price, and they're only going to be on your website 4 or 5 seconds and then they leave because it doesn't work in their budget, or they need more bedrooms, or they need more bathrooms. And that's not good for your website, that's not good for your SEO. So we provide as much value as we can without showing our whole hand. We want the viewer to be empowered by what they've seen. And then when they actually click through and click on learn more, they will be willing to fill out the form with their information, which auto-populates. It's great, it's easy for them to do. And then they're rewarded by going through to the website and seeing all the pictures, all the video, the maps, the guides, all the information, contact forms, everything they need in one place. And they've already engaged with that because you've already provided them with information. So when they're on the website, they're a good audience member on your website that take time to look around and you're providing a credible set of information for them. Providing a credible set of information for them. So one thing that we also do, Brandon touched on it, is running A, B, and C ads, or more, or sometimes less, depending on which property that we're focusing on. So primarily, an A ad for us is we don't define any demographics on it. We just blanket our area that the property is located in, because we want everybody in that area to know there's a listing. Even if they're not currently looking to buy, it's not wasted ad spend because it's brand awareness. It's building your brand. It's them seeing you all the time. You want to be visible, noticeable, and memorable. Then B and C ads, we focus on different areas, and this is where you can include demographics. And I know there was a question earlier in the chat about demographics, and it certainly has changed with the new ad laws through Facebook. The main problem that I find is that you can't refine the area as much. Like, you have to do a larger area. You can't focus in on just a few streets or a small community if your ad is going to be viewed in a radius of 25 kilometers and above. But through command, the demographic that you can choose is perhaps not as powerful as Facebook Ad Manager, but I find the algorithm that Command has that works with Facebook means that we're actually showing our property to a lot more people. So it kind of balances out.
For a lot less money.
A lot less money, yeah. So in regards to the interests where you can refine your audience, as mentioned, it's not as powerful as Facebook Ad Manager. What I love in Facebook Ad Manager, and hopefully Command will bring this feature in, is say that you've got a waterfront listing that's boat access only. Not just can you target boat users, you can actually search for boat brands so that you can hit up people that maybe own a Yamaha boat or a Sea-Doo boat. And you can then also target pages on Facebook, such as if the local marina has a Facebook page, you can make sure the ad is viewed by everybody that has a like on that page. If you've got a fixer-upper property, you can target like HGTV, people that have interest in that. Devotion in command doesn't work quite as refined as that, but hopefully it will get there. But it's a great way of defining your audience so that in more densely populated areas, for instance, when we run our ad in Toronto, we don't want to waste ad spend on just everybody seeing it. We actually want it to be in front of the eyes of people that want to see it. So for instance, with an income property, you can target interest for investments and money management, leases, landlord pages, etc. It's there's a lot of tools in there. And I find that when you search through the search toolbar, it's not as good as actually just take the time to go through the list and just select the audiences that you think fits that property one by one. It'll take just 5 minutes, but it works really well. And it really does refine who sees your ad. So we've been running ads for, the last year, but in the last couple of months, we've switched primarily to command. Running our ads through that, we've had a lot of success through it. In the last 2 months alone, we've close to 130,000 impressions, and we've had 720 leads. It's actually more since yesterday. I think we've had about 12 or 13 more leads since yesterday. And our current spend is about 40 cents per lead. We don't often spend less than $400 a month. That's not just on listings. That's also on CMA ads or just general brand awareness ads, or if we're running a competition or something like that. So it's not just on listings, but per listing we spend around $30. We'll get 75 to 80 leads, and it can be a lot for our agents. So we've actually got Adam here who's going to talk about how you can deal with all those leads coming in, because they come in from a wide range of people, such as people that just want to click through and will actually take the opportunity to use the lead form to swear at you, all the way through to buyers that are very interested and have viewed your ad, looked through the website, filled out the form, and want to buy a property, have a listing to sell, a property to list as well. So it's a wide variety of leads, and that can be quite troublesome for people to deal with. So yeah, Adam's going to talk about how he deals with that.
Cool. Thanks, Rob. And thanks, Brandon, for starting off, and everybody that was able to help put this together. My name is Adam Edge. I'm one of the co-founders of For Sale on Georgian Bay. And without this man right here, we'd be way back. So thanks, Rob, for all your hard work. From the lead, receiving the lead aspect in command was a little bit of a rocky road getting started. Everybody adjusting from, original Facebook advertising to command. Rob messaged us the night before, and it was like, hey, command ads are live, blah, blah, blah. Next morning, we woke up and everybody was like, holy shit, what do we do? Like, there was quite a few in there not expecting this drastic change, going from advertising in the same platform but just doing it through command. So it was very important for me, and trying to get people on the team as well, is to initiate your response. If you're on the fly, you're in the car, you're about to go into an appointment, and you get that email that you got a new lead, you can either pass and it's going to go to the next person in line, because we have it set up as a completely transparent, 100% even round robin rotation. So if you miss your turn, tough titty. It goes to the next person. So with responding and having them on being able to have that smart plan available for your first initiated contact, so you're giving that quick response to that lead. You can do what you got to do and then call them when you get back or when you have your first chance to actually make that phone call. We haven't per se have any closed deals just yet for many leads that we do have, but obviously we've met with clients, people are set up on property searches and whatnot, and we're getting there with the you know, with getting these contacts and meeting them and actually getting them up here from the city as well. Majority of them are all from the city. You get a few based on our local ads that we're running on, you know, people just curious, whatever. So I'm a big cold caller. So if you get these people on the phone or you get a response from an email or you can get them on the phone as well, they're just looking, no, they're not interested in viewing this property per se. I just go right into my cold call script. Great. Do you have an agent in the area that you would work with if you were to pull the plug tomorrow or pull the trigger tomorrow on buying a property? Well, no, not really. We haven't thought of it, yada, yada. Great. Well, you know, one day you may be looking to do that, and I would love that opportunity to work with you when that day comes. Would it be all right to stay in touch? And if they say yes to staying in touch, you have their info already. You have their email. You have their phone number. I do a monthly, bi-weekly email to everybody in my database, and just to stay in touch and stay in touch with my cold call people as well. But like Brandon said, this is like today's modern door knocking. Well, you can still be out there cold calling and or door knocking, or just being present in public and talking to strangers. They can look at you weird because people look at you weird when you talk to them now. But anyway, I just wanted to add in that those smart plans part of command, I find are super important because it does a lot of the back end work that you don't have to focus on. You could be making those calls and those emails can be being sent out on their own and going from there. So that's what I got. Are we there?
There were slides, Robert?
Yes, amazing. Thank you.
If anybody has any questions?
I think there's quite a few questions.
All right, question time. Please unmute and ask away. Okay. Let's
I have a question.
Yeah, go ahead.
Salima here. I just wanted to thank you very much for all of you and sharing your information. I just wanted to know, for is videos do better than posts, or is that kind of the same in terms of getting the leads?
Can I jump in quickly?
Sure.
Go ahead.
So I would have to say, and again, Robert, you guys can probably agree or disagree. It all depends on what your budget is and how you target your audience. Like, again, you're going through the algorithm and kind of tailoring what the property has and what the potential buyer is looking for. So it all depends, and it matters how you actually nurture that specific algorithm in order to generate the leads. So you can have an incredible video, and I have seen it where I posted a video and I literally got like maybe 3 or 4 leads. I didn't get many leads, but then I had to go back in, refine the algorithm, tailor it to what the consumer was looking for. And then that same video was like, hey, 5 leads. Okay. 35 leads, totally different. So do videos do better than photos? That's a debate. It all depends on how you kind of rhythm. Robert, what do you think?
For us, I find that videos work better on our regular social feeds compared to the actual ad spend. I think it's about risk because people are just scrolling through at high speed on their phone. They might only give your post 2 or 3 seconds, 5 seconds maybe, of concentration. Compared to a video, you know, in a video in 5 seconds, what have you seen? You might have just introduced yourself. That's if the person has videos with the mute turned off so that they can actually hear what you're saying. Whereas with 5 seconds on an image, they've seen everything that's on the image. So videos work great, but I find for us, they work just better on our regular social feed when it's our regular people that want to follow us and not people that we're invading their timeline with our information.
Okay, good information. That's really good. Now, I just actually have a question for you. So in regards to the leads that you do have coming in, what is the quality of those leads? Like if you're getting like, say, 75 leads, what's the quality of them?
I'd say it's about as good as door knocking.
Okay, so you're interactive, you're gathering information with them.
Whether you get a response, an answered phone call, a text, any of that. I mean, I'm not one that's super, super aggressive. If I can't get you, you know, the first couple times and connect, I like to connect, and obviously from there you move on. But I'm not super aggressive in that aspect. Like some of these smart plans you can go on command are like super aggressive. I would never in a million years. I'm authentic. That's not something I would do. So why come off as that type of person? Right. So, I don't know. I feel the smart plans is really cool, but the quality. Yeah. I mean, it's like door knocking or cold calling. You're going to get, you know, I do a cold calling session. I can get 5 to 10 emails of people who don't have an agent, are willing to stay in touch, looking to maybe make a move, yada, 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 get on my market report. And I can get 10 of those in like an hour.
That's amazing. That's really good. Now with all that, sorry, go ahead.
From there, they just go into my MailChimp. They go on a smart plan. They go on a quarterly call depending on their, you know, our conversation. Maybe they go on a monthly smart plan. And I don't do Twilio. I don't do different phone numbers until Twilio and come up with something where we can use our own personal phone numbers. I think Twilio and that whole thing is useless, but that's just my opinion.
I agree with you on that.
Yeah, I think that at the end of the day, once they figure that out, that'll be super cool because now I can really put people on a text smart plan as well as email. And I don't even have to physically do the text, which is fantastic.
Totally.
So yeah, I mean, we're all still learning. Mm-hmm. Some days I want to take my laptop with command in it and throw it out the window.
I'm right with you on that. I want to do some UFC kick moves on that laptop. I get so annoyed. But while we're talking about that, just so everyone knows, Twilio is basically an automated phone service that basically when someone leaves information, you can then send pre-recorded text messages that update the consumer of information they requested. Yeah. And now while I was just asking about the quality of the leads, so how often do you guys see people leaving information through command that is fake information so that when they inquire, it's not their phone number and not their name?
Yeah, notachance@gmail.com. And this one's phone number is 905-999-99999.
Yeah. Well, how often do you do that?
Delete, whatever, right? Move on. We have it in a round robin. So yeah, we all get them. And you know, I've converted a few buyers. Karen's got a few, you know, we are starting to convert some of these leads and talk to people. The brand awareness is definitely happening. You know, when you meet at the cottage there, you see some family friends like, oh my God, we see your ads everywhere. Like we hear it all the time. Really, it's the brand awareness that's working.
I agree.
I think that we certainly do get fake information, but I actually see every single lead coming in, and it is a fairly small percentage of them overall.
Okay, good. Yeah, because I know that's a lot of people do ask those kind of questions. Oh, like with the leads that you have coming in, like, are they real information? Because like, you know, when you knock on someone's door and they say, oh, hi, my name is Greg, but it's actually Robert. And then they give you a fake number and you call it and you're like, well, we just talked today. But it's like, no, that's not who I am, you know? But yeah, I see a couple of like weird emails and it's like, well, this guy definitely doesn't want to talk to me. But yeah. Any other questions that anyone may have regarding what we've discussed today?
Hey, Robert, I've just got a comment if you got a second. Are you there? Can you hear me? Yeah. Because of what you and Brandon said, they said I came from a 25-year television advertising background. I'm having huge success with command and leads and stuff like that. And I'm finding the quality of leads is way, way, way higher, but only because of the lessons you guys have just taught. It is targeted specific things. You know, who wants to live down here by the waterfront? Nobody looking for a downtown condo is clicking on that. So it is, you couldn't have explained it or told it better. And I've spent, like I said, I think I've spent over $30,000 like 35 plus on Facebook over the years. And it's those targeted ads, those genuine being yourself ads that are creating 10 times the lead. And I'm going to hopefully beat out of KW cost per lead. I could care less. If an agent sent me a referral, I'm paying 25% commission. So I'm okay with $100 or $200 per client, not per lead. And right now I'm running on an average through Command and everything I'm doing, I'm at about $38 cost per client. I could care less about leads. I want clients, not leads. Anyone can, you can buy 1,000 leads from anybody and you know, they can be 100% useless. But with Command and with the guidance that you just gave these, this group, it is that specificness that is has just been huge. I'm, you know, I've done, hey, did you know that there's still 2-bedroom, 2-bathroom condos available in this area that still allow full rentals? Guess what I'm getting? Perfect leads. You know, I did a giveaway one day that I forgot to advertise. And so I spent $20 on it. I got 12 leads. 6 people showed up to an event to get a free pumpkin. And 4 of them are active buyers right now. $5 cost per client. So, but again, I so enjoyed listening to the power and the way you guys are using it because people will spend years practicing and not being genuine and natural and targeted, just like you've said. So thanks.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right. Any other questions before we wrap up? Come on. Going once, going twice. Well, in behalf of Aaron. Yeah, go ahead. Sorry. What was that?
I hit the button on my phone. It was ready to call 911 there. That's
all right. Well, in behalf of everyone, Brandon, Robert, Adam, thank you so much for this information that you shared. It is money. It is gold. Golden. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much.
Welcome.
So for more information, check out the chat room. For non-KW agents, please email k.ellis@kw.com. For KW agents, you know where to go. Visit our site, visit our YouTube page. Again, thank you so much. You've been amazing, guys. Thank you. And until next time, thank you so much. Round of applause.
Thanks, everyone, for coming. I appreciate it.
That was great, guys.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Thanks, guys. You rock.
Bye, everyone. Yeah. Absolutely.